Welcome back. In this video, we will go over the anatomy of the long bone. Right here, we have the femur, which is an example of a long bone. This right here is an actual femur from a human. A long bone has two ends right here and a shaft. Each end is called apophysis. This right here is the proximal apophysis, which articulate with the hip bone to form the hip joint. This right here is the distal apophysis, which articulates with the tibia and the patella, which forms the knee joint. The shaft is called diaphysis. This right here is the head, which is the rounded apophysis. This is the neck. The neck is the bony connection between the head and the diaphysis. In the apophysis, we have the epiphyseal line, which is not shown on this bone because it's a cross section. The epiphyseal line is the boundary between the apophysis and the diaphysis. The epiphyseal line, it replaces the epiphyseal growth plate, which is a plate of cartilage in the long bones. It's present during childhood. When we reach puberty, the cartilage ossifies and turns to the epiphyseal line. This cartilage allows the long bone to grow in length. Both ends of long bones, they are covered by the articular cartilage. Articular cartilage is a cartilage which consists of hyaline cartilage that covers the ends of long bones where the articulation, meaning a joint, forms. Without the articular cartilage, the bone erodes. And this leads to arthritis, which is the inflammation of the joint. So that is the importance of having the articular cartilage. Moving to the periosteum, which is a dense, fibrous connective tissue that covers the external surface of the bone. Peri means around, osteum, the bone. Don't confuse the articular cartilage with the periosteum, which covers the entire bone. Okay. Moving to the diaphysis, we can see this space right here, which is the medullary cavity. The medullary cavity is filled with the yellow bone marrow. It is surrounded by the compact bone. We can see the compact bone right here, which consists of osteons. And we can see also the spongy bone, which has these tiny openings, the trabecula. The spongy bone also, it fills the ends of long bone. The spongy bone on each end is filled with the red marrow, which forms the blood cells. Notice how the compact bone on the ends, it gets thinner and it surrounds the entire spongy bone right here. Osteoporosis is a bone condition that affects the spongy bone. This right here is the external surface of the bone. We can see the compact bone right here. We can also see the spongy bone, which is covered by the compact bone on this end. I hope you found the video helpful. Check out my video on the anatomy of the femur to understand its structures in detail.